Respected professors, faculty members of Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College. Through this video lecture, I am going to explain the POCO attainment calculation. So we are in the process of preparing document for NBA accreditation, and one component is POCO attainment. This is included in the course end report. We are supposed to prepare the course end report for the previous semester subject. So what we taught. So through this video lecture, I will try to explain you the procedure how to prepare the course end report. To start with, I take the NBA document. 3.2.2 record of attainment of course outcome of all the courses with respect to set attainment level. So we are the affiliated institution, so we have to follow the procedure given in the NBA. We have only two methods for assessment of the course outcome. One is the internal assessment test, and another is Anna University end semester examination. So what is important here? So the attainment level. So examples of attainment level for university exam, measuring course outcome attained through university examination. What is given here? Attainment level 1, 2, 3. 60% students scoring more than university average percentage of mark are set to attainment level in the final examination. What is the university average percentage of mark? That we do not know. So we take 60% of students pass in the university examination, final examination, 70% attainment level 2, 70%, and attainment level 3 is 80%. Now we modified it. So this is what the minimum, it is what given in the NBA document. We have level 1, 60%, level 2, 65%, and level 3, 70%. Similarly for internal assessment test, CO. Measuring CO attainment through internal assessment. Again, you look at the statement, the examples indicated are for reference only. Program may appropriately define the level. So we have the liberty to define the level. So here again, we have three levels, attainment level 1, 2, 3. So level 1, 60% students scoring more than 60% out of 60% mark out of the relevant maximum mark. So what we have fixed here, 60% students scoring more than 50% mark in the relevant CO. So the 60% also we have reduced to 50%. The 60 we maintain as it is. So 70 is changed to 65 and 80 is changed to 70. So 60% level 1, 60% students scoring more than 50% mark in the relevant CO. Level 2, 65% students scoring more than 50% mark in the relevant CO. And the level 3, 70% students scoring more than 50% mark in the relevant CO. That is what the procedure. And once you measure everything, this is what the weightage. So look at the weightage. 80% weightage for the university examination and 20% weightage for the internal assessment test. So finally, when you calculate, when we calculate the course outcome, this is what the measuring procedure, 80% of the university examination and 20% of the internal assessment test. And this CO attainment will be carried for the PO and PSO attainment. So how? So first we'll discuss the CO attainment calculation. What is the first requirement? We have to complete this. The internal mark, cycle test mark analysis report. So this we have started last semester. At the end of every cycle test we have calculated, but this you have to complete. At least those who have completed is well and good, otherwise you have to complete it. This is the minimum first requirement. So you have to prepare the internal mark analysis report using the Excel sheet. So what is my course, what was my course is thermal engineering for the secondary mechanical engineering section B. Again, everything, attainment level, description, correlation, everything is given here. And the question number CO, relevant CO, the Bloom's level, and the mark for the every question, it is also given here. And the entire question paper, and the CO1 in the question paper, CO2 in the question paper. So in the first cycle test, CO1 it is 32 mark, CO2 it is 18 mark, and Bloom's level 1, 2, 3 it is also distributions given. And what is the, you prepare the name list and the mark obtained by the student is entered here. Right, so mark obtained by the student in the every question from the front page of the answer sheet, it is given in the Excel sheet. Now look at the table here, calculation. CO1, what is the mark scored by this particular student on the CO1? It is a formula and you have to calculate CO1 mark, CO2 mark, and all the mark scored by the student CO1, CO2, it is given here. And finally, coming to the last, number of students obtained more than 50% mark in the relevant CO. So here it is 21. It is a formula, counting formula. So the 32 is the maximum mark, 50% is 16. So 16 and above. And similarly, 18, it is 9 and above. Right? And percentage of students obtained more than 50% mark in relevant CO is 31% and 26%. What is the correlation level achieved? So minimum requirement is 60. So there is no achieved. It is not actual, so 0, 0. It is the cycle test 1. Similarly, cycle test 2. So cycle test 2, for all the question papers, we have entered the mark. CO1, all the, as per the question paper, right? So we have conducted the test for 100 marks. So all the calculations are given here. And once again, what is the percentage? For number of students scored more than 50, it is 42, 50, 41 out of 68 students. Now, what is the percentage? 62, 74, and 60. So, the correlation level, 61, 62% is 1, 70 and above is 3, and 60% is 1. So, this is for the cycle test 2. Similarly, cycle test 3. And for cycle test 3, again, I have to enter the details here. Question paper, Bloom's level, mark level, everything. It is again for 100 marks we have conducted. And coming to the calculation here. So this is CO1 to CO5. And all the calculations are given. 46 students, 54 students, 37 students, 11 students, and 4 students. Above 50% mark. So 68%, 79%, 54%, 16%, 11%. And what is the correlation level? First CO2, second CO3, and all the other CO is 0. So this is for cycle test 1, cycle test 2, and cycle test 3. Now coming to the report. So this is the consolidated report. Again, for the including all the cycle tests. Here you may have one doubt. For the second year, we have conducted 4 cycle tests in the previous semester. 4th test was conducted, but I have not included here. Why for my subject, why I have not included? The number of students absent was 39 out of 68, more than 50% student, and the mark scored by student is not also not satisfactory. I have removed, so I have not considered the 4th cycle test for the assessment. And again, the cycle test 1, CO2, CO1, CO2, cycle test 2, CO2, CO3, CO4, and cycle test 3, total mark. So cumulative report. So from the previous 3 Excel sheets, the data is transferred here. And once again, for the cumulative cycle test performance, you have calculated. So the mark here, it is sum of CO1, this is sum of CO2, sum of CO3, sum of CO4, and sum of CO5. And here it is number of students scored more than 50% mark. And here it is the percentage of student scored more than 50% mark, and this is what the correlation level. So for CO1, it is 0 because minimum is 60%. CO1 0, CO2 0, CO3 72%, third level, and the CO4 and CO5 equal to 0. So this report we have to complete first. So the mark analysis for theory paper and practical paper, those who have not prepared, completed. So please take your time and complete this exercise first. Then we go to the course end report, preparation of the course end report. This is the format, or the you can use as a reference. I will share with you the Word document. You can use it as a reference. So the course and report, even semester 2018-19, program B mechanical engineering, semester and section, fourth semester B section, 2017-21 batch. So this you include in all the document, because this is required for calculating the program attainment, PO attainment for that particular batch. Number of students 68, course code, subject code, number of credit, course coordinator, program coordinator. Then the title, COPO attainment analysis at the end of the semester. So based on the course outcome. So what are the course outcome? This is available in your course plan. You just copy and paste here. And the course as outcome assessment method, IA test 1, IA test 2, IA test 3, and a university examination. And what is the scheme? So I have internal assessment test, internal assessment test 1, 2, 3. So the mark distribution in the relevant CO, so cycle test 1 conducted in 29-1-2019, maximum mark 50, CO 1 32, CO 2 18. IA test 2, 25-19, 100 marks, CO 2 17, CO 3 70, CO 4 13. Internal assessment test 3, 18-3-19, maximum mark 100, CO 1 8 mark, CO 2 8 mark, CO 3 8 mark, CO 4 28 mark, and CO 5 48 mark. Anonymous examination, you take the question paper and do the analysis, you calculate. So 9-5-19 was the date conducted. So CO 1 32 mark, CO 2 17 mark, CO 3 17 mark, and CO 4 32 mark, and CO 5 17 mark. Normally part A, there will be 2 questions, 4 marks. Part B, there will be 1 question, 13 marks, so 17 is the normal mark. So here, 15 mark question, part C question, it was asked in the unit number 1 and unit number 4. So I included 15 marks here in the unit 1, CO 1 and CO 4. Now the CO attainment in internal assessment test. So this is what the table, given in your course plan, just to copy it and paste here. So here, you just check it up. So 60, 65, 70. That you have to look into. So if there is a, if you just pay, copy and paste, you should not carry 60, 70, 80. So 60, 65 and 70, this is what the correction. And this is what the report. Again, from the Excel sheet, you can take the data and type here. So you can prepare the cumulative report. Average of CO attainment for the course. So the average of these values. It is what? Correlation level of CO1, CO2, CO3, CO4 divided by 5. For me, this course, it is 0.6. So, these through internal assessment test, what is the attainment? It is 0.6. Okay. Then report on internal assessment test, you have to write a report here. So, for this is the topic. Here, my duty is I have to write a report. Explaining why the performance is poor in cycle test 1, cycle test 2, cycle test 3, and why if you look at CO1, it is 0, CO2, it is 0, what is CO1, CO2 in the cycle test 1, or cycle test, if you look at the cycle test 2, it is better, cycle test 3, again it is poor. So there is a fluctuation in the performance of the student in the cycle test. So how to improve the situation in the classroom. So explaining all these things, I have to give a report here. So it is also for you, based on your correlation level, your subject correlation level, you have to give a report, right? If your report, if your results are good, if your achievement level is better, then you have to find, then there is another method, another way we have to go for increasing the target level that we'll discuss later. So first you prepare the document, and write your report. Then CO attainment in the Anna University examination. Again, the table from the previous course plan. You just copy and paste here. Here again, you verify, check it up, 60, 65, 70. And this is what the university analysis for my subject. Class 10th is 68. Number of students appeared is 68. Number of students pass is only 22. The pass percentage is 32.35. And the grade distribution is this. And again, the percentage is only 32.35. What is achievement level? Minimum percentage is 60% is required. So it is not achieved. It is not, it is only 0. So again, once again, I have to write a report here. Why the performance of the student, the Anna University examinations are poor. and what are the methodology to improve the performance of the student. Then CO attainment, see course outcome attainment, what is the weightage of internal assessment test 20 mark, what weightage of another university examination 80 mark, 80%. So CO attainment, 80% of another university, which is 0, 20% of internal assessment test, it was 0.6. So finally, it is 0.12. So the course outcome attainment is 0.12 for this particular course. And this is to be used for PO attainment through the particular subject. So PO and PSO attainment using the CO attainment. And what is the methodology to measure, attain the PO and PSO? There are two methods, direct method and indirect method. Direct method is using the course outcome. Indirect method is using the exit survey, alumni survey or employer survey. So this we will do every year for a particular batch of the student. So for this particular batch, we have to do it later. So this will be done only at the end of the program when these students are completing the course. 2017-21 batch completing their course. So the final PO attainment for this batch will be done later. Now we calculate the PO, PSO attainment through this particular subject alone. Mapping of PO and PSO and CO. So this mapping is already, it is there in your course plan. You just copy and paste. The column which are not required, you just delete. And direct method of attainment of PO and PSO. So the average level, sir, it is here. This is what the average level. What is the CO attainment? Final CO attainment, it is 0.12. So it is from here. And for, this is what the target level. And this is what the CO attainment. So for this target level, how to find out attainment of PO and PSO? So 3.12, it is 0.12, because your target of PO1 is 3, attainment of CO is 0.12, for 3 it is 0.12, right? So for 2, what is the value? For 2, what is the value? For 1, what is the value? For 3 is the maximum 0.12. So this is what the attainment. So this mark will be carried to this table in our future calculation. So this is the program level course matrix. So here we have to carry the mark C406. So you have to put the mark and you have to calculate the vertically. And finally, for the particular batch, we have to calculate the PO attainment and PSO attainment. So this we will do later. So you try to complete the course end report. So what is required? First, we have to prepare the, we have to complete the Excel sheet for the cycle test mark analysis for the batch, for the particular subject. Then you have to prepare the Word document. So here we can do some, for when the committee visits, we can have some some bar chart representing the result in the form of bar chart that we'll do later. First, you prepare the document. So bar chart we'll do maybe for the individual teachers. If you are okay, you can include the bar chart. So with the result analysis, you can put up in the form of a bar chart. So for that, you can refer to the document shared by the principal. So thank you.